Selector of anchor and target element put together, they are called relative selectors. So how to create a relative selector? This is something we are going to learn. Relative selector is generally created from UI Explorer. You have seen in anchor based activity, we are using two different elements. One is the anchor for which we are selecting, and the other one is your target element, right? So this time what we are going to do, instead of having two different selectors, we are going to incorporate both indicate element selector and indicate anchor selector at the same one. So that will be called as a relative selector. So let's see how this works, right? So for this one, I'm going to click on indicate element, and in the background, let's open the rpachallenge.com website, and here let's take any of it. Let's say, for example, first name. So here I said indicate element. This is my target element where I want to type something or whatever I want to do. That one I need to select for the relative selector. Okay, so I'm selecting the element, the target element, and the next thing I'm going to do is indicate anchor. So you can see the selector of that target element has been uploaded. So now after this, after you select this, click on indicate anchor. Okay, and here my anchor is first name. Okay, so right now what is happening, you will see both the anchor and the element are getting highlighted here. Okay, so the anchor here is first name. If you see, the active accessibility name equals to first name is becomes my anchor, and where I have to type, right, that will become the input. So here one thing you need to always remember, anywhere you find ID or the index, right, this ID number are always, I mean, they keep on changing, they are not constant. So remember, whenever you find a ID in your selector, try to uncheck that from this item. So here let's scroll and see, okay, the ID is over here, let me uncheck that. Okay, so once you uncheck, try to validate. So if you see, this is working fine with the background data. So now what I'm going to do, I am going to change the page. For example, first name is on the top. If I hit on submit, okay, the first name is still on top. Okay, now the first name has come over here, right, at the down. So if I try to validate now, will it work? Okay, so let's see that. So it should get a green tick mark. So this kind of selectors where you are including both anchor and element, all the selectors in the same one, will be called as relative selector. So just wait for a couple of seconds and it should get validated. Okay, it got validated. Now what I'm going to do, I'm going to copy entire thing. So this has got both the things, right? So not unlike your anchor base, where you are having an anchor, for that there is a selector, then you have an element where you want to target, that is having another selector. So two selectors. This time I'm going to include both of them in one, and I'm going to use it. So how to use that is again quite simple. For example, I'm using a highlight activity. So any kind of activity you can take. So if I take a highlight activity, and here in the highlight, in the selector, what I'm going to do, I'm going to copy paste that. Go to selector. Okay. And here in the selector, what you do, write a double quote and copy paste the entire thing that you had got. Okay. And click on OK. So that way we will see if it is working or not. Okay. So let me run it. So it should be able to highlight the first name target element. So let me keep this in the background. Okay, so you can see it is working. Now what if I change the page and I go to the next page? Right now the first name is here. Okay, so if I run it now, so you can put it in a loop or whatever you want, you can do that. So now if I do this, let's see if okay, you can see this time also it has highlighted the first name. So guys, this is called a relative selector. So remember, this will be very useful, and you should know what is a relative selector. When anybody tells you use a relative selector, she should know what it is. So thank you very much guys for learning this. Please continue with our channel. Please do subscribe in case you have not subscribed to our channel yet. Please do like all the videos for all the efforts our team is putting to bring forward a lot of knowledge on UiPath. Please do support us by hitting on the like button and having some comments for our team. Thank you guys. You guys have a great day.